What's going on, guys? Welcome back to Europa Universalis IV as Holland. In the previous part, we fought a pretty good war against Burgundy and its allies, which we ended up piecing out early because it wasn't my war. It was actually Liège's war, but I'm their ally, so I joined them, and so did... Well, it's a pretty big war. As you can see, this is everybody that Burgundy's fighting, but it includes Austria, is obviously very, very big and strong. So, because of that, we ended up occupying all of Flanders, and we peaced out in a separate deal, and we demanded that we get these two provinces. So now the Holland, because it's not really the Netherlands yet, but we've grown, we now have these two provinces, and somehow, miraculously, we're not actually able to walk over here. I guess because it's not at all attached by land. I wish it had like a little piece of land so you could just cross, but nope, not possible. So we actually have to use transport ships to get across this ocean. That's kind of stupid, but that's the way it is. But yeah, we got some pretty good provinces out of that deal. We're currently dealing with making a core there, so that we're not dealing with this massive overextension, because that actually causes a lot of negative effects, which we don't want. So we're taking care of that. Like, it leads to corruption, as we can see, and a bunch of other things, so we're taking care of that right now as we speak. We also, during that war, and this is like the best part, we got subsidies from France. They were like, okay, we have interests in Holland. We want them to do well for whatever reason. Possibly because I was fighting Burgundy. So they ended up giving me subsidies for like quite a while. I don't know how long they'll actually give this to me though. Is there a way to check? I don't think so. I think it's for like 10 years or something. But they basically double my income because of this. Clave is now my rival. They're only ally with Cologne. Like, what are you gonna do with Cologne there, buddy? Where is Cologne again? Should be... Yeah, it's these guys. So, that's not gonna be a thing. I can tell that right now. We could definitely try to either vassalize or take some of their land. Thing is, we're dealing with some pretty negative aggressive expansion. Because we took two provinces just like that. So we gotta be really careful that we don't push it too far and end up sort of imploding our starting little empire. So we're playing it safe, because that certainly seems like the wise choice here. Actually, let's transport these guys across the ocean. There we go. We want to be over there, because that way, when rebels spawn, we're going to be ready for them, and also we'll have troops on the ground, which will reduce unrest by itself. Because right now it's 3.7, and now it's 2.7, and we have a lot more soldiers on the way. And I'm pretty sure we should be able to have even more pretty soon, since we have 8 provinces now. Yeah, we're like on the verge of getting a 14th unit or regiment. I mean, that's just really nice. I think we did pretty well for ourselves in that war. I was planning on actually taking this part, but okay, here we go. Control's being reverted. Royal marriage with France, sure. Do that. We're currently dealing with some legitimacy problems because our heir is a weak claim. That's not great. There were actually some rebels that rose up, tried to, I guess, depose our king. Oh no. No longer relevant to their interests, and therefore their subsidies will be cancelled. Okay. Well, we got advantage from that for like at least a year, I think. I mean, it's a good amount of money. Let's see. 30% chance of the rebels growing stronger in their support. Okay, let's see. We have 12 lightships who are actually protecting our trade, so that's good. And our natural scientist has died. National text modifier. That's actually a really nice one. Yeah, grab that guy. Get him on board. And we're not getting too many military points, but that's alright. Because what we want is either this technology or this idea. We want to be able to actually reach areas that we can colonize, and we're just not quite there yet, so we need to save up a bit and just oh, they're fighting again. Look at that. Look, I'm just hoping that Liège will sort of peace out of this war soon, because I want to make sure that I get this province, and if possible I'd like to add this to it as well. Like, if I could just vassalize all of Brabant, that would be very nice, because that would actually form like a greater Netherlands, which is like, it's the Netherlands at that point. If you get Limburg as well, like these two. And then if we can include even more, we will have like a greater Netherlands, which I would love to do. So I guess we'll see. We also have to make a core here, though. Like, we want to have cores in both of these provinces. It'll cost me a bunch of administrative points, but that overextension is a real nasty thing to deal with. So let's just take care of that, is what I'm saying. Why is this guy just sitting there? This fleet is protecting my trade, but they're mostly just kind of sitting out there. Alright, let's improve relations with France for a bit. And if possible, yeah, these guys aren't very happy. Maybe Trier or something. Thing is, we can't have any more allies. We're full there. We're allied to Liège. Maybe, yeah, let's just improve with Castile as well. They are my ally after all. Yeah, Burgundy's gonna lose this war though. As long as Austria remains at large doing stuff. Right now, I don't see him. And I think I was like the second largest force after Austria, so they probably actually really needed me in that war. But hey, I'm not turning down these provinces. These are really good. They got some alright trade power, but they actually have pretty nice production. They have... Okay, my explorer died. They also have some really nice, especially Ghent has some really nice, well, this one too. This one's got crazy manpower, this one actually has a lot of production and tax. So it was just nice to add that to my little kingdom here. Even though we're not really a kingdom yet. And I don't think we can be a kingdom for quite a while. Ooh, we're actually almost halfway there, okay. That's hopeful. We can probably be a kingdom pretty soon, maybe. Denmark's fighting. Ooh, that's gonna be an issue. Denmark is fighting Dithmarschen. But this is a free city of the Holy Roman Empire, so I don't think they're gonna be able to take that. Then again, Denmark isn't involved in that. What? These guys are, for some reason, my sworn enemy, but I've never, like, had any interaction with them. Lübeck, and they're just sitting there. Being angry at me, and I just don't really know why. There's some stuff going down here as well. Apparently Muscovy is fighting Lithuania. Danish, that's Danish land right there. How'd he do that? Because this is where... Let's see, I'm not entirely sure. I should be sure though. Yeah, this should be where, St. Petersburg is, right? Or actually, this might be it. It's either this or that. I'm not sure. Because this is like Finland and this is Estonia. I'm not entirely sure. Okay. Not that it matters. I'm just kind of curious. Alright, so we cored this province, so there's a lot less unrest, and soon it should be at zero. Oh my god. England paid all foreign debt of Austria. Why would you do that? Seems strange to make that choice. Okay, we also got a lot of money though, which we might want to spend on various buildings. Yeah, one of these might be good. If we get a regimental camp, we can have a larger army. Let's make one up there. Yeah, the rest of it kind of seems like a waste, so we'll just save up money for now. We're good. Okay. Rowan has a new leader. It looks like Liège actually took one of their provinces only. No, actually they got Limburg. Oh, that could be bad. That's not very good for me. I just gotta make sure that I actually get this. Oh, and that's what I'm talking about. They're no longer the vassal of Burgundy. Which means they also have no allies, by the way. As soon as this little truce that we have is over, I am going to be able to declare war on them again. But it'll be another 8 years, okay. The discovery of the New World has heralded a new era not only for the colonizers and the colonized. This has led to a spread of materials and techniques as well as a realization of the vast size of the globe. Animals, crop types, silver, and diseases spread across the Atlantic. The first steps have been taken towards... There should be like a period there, right? a truly global economy, as foreign lands and people are mapped and documented ideals, as well as religious and philosophical debate has become more and more colored by what we have found in overseas societies. Great minds feel the need to question what was once truth, and from Valladolid, which is like, or with a B, I guess, it's like in Spain, right? To Fatehpur Sikri, the nature of the world is now up for debate. So that's like the new institution. The first one that we saw was Renaissance, which we have embraced. This one usually, I believe, starts in Portugal. So I think we should be able to get it pretty soon. I hope so, at least. Okay. They see me as a rival. Hey, that's pretty good. We're rivals now. Can I rival them? I would be into that. Let's see. One of the cardinals has proven to be a skilled administrator. All right, okay, so it's like get 10 prestige, or you get extra missionary strength and extra papal influence. Stuff like that. Like, that's fine. I don't really care about the influence or the prestige, because that's actually going to go down pretty quickly. I would prefer the extra yearly influence in the papal stuff. So I'm going to go with that. I want to still try and beat a controller. It's probably not going to happen, but, you know, I'd like to try. Can we get a 14th unit yet? Yes, we can. Yes, we can, but we're still recovering our manpower right now. And this is going to take forever and a half. This is the part that really sucks. Like, our whole army was sort of decimated. Oh, they actually took a bit of Burgundy as well. So they took this province from those guys, and they took... No, actually, they took this province. Yeah, it looks like it's about right. They took this province and that province. Okay, so at least Burgundy is like kind of smaller. They lost some of their vassals as well. Apparently, they're no longer leading any personal union. Right, because I took Flanders and they took Brabant, or they're now like, they forced them to annul that treaty. That's a thing that you can do after a war. Hey, that's good for me. Okay, at least they like me. No aggressive expansion, or not too bad. I'm gonna wait for this to go down by a bunch, though. I would hate for this guy, for example, to have a reason to murder me or Bohemia. They're not too bad. Austria, though. Austria could be a thing. Not too aggressive. All right. Okay, so Vienna is under attack by Norway. You gotta explain that to me for a second. What is going on? All right, so Denmark is fighting a bunch of people. They went after Dithmarschen, but they're like a free city, so they had the protection of the empire. Which is why all these other parties are getting involved now. And now they have rebels to deal with, apparently. All right, so they're fighting the green dudes over there. They're fighting Dithmarschen, Austria, and Ferrara. But why Ferrara? Because they're like down here, right? So what's going on there? That's so strange. Like, the politics in this game are so weird. I also gotta say, it's kind of interesting to see that Florence is being eaten by the papal state. The Pope's hungry. Very hungry, okay. I think Austria took this from... Did they always have that? They're the only people with a core there. So strange. I mean, some of this stuff is just very strange. Okay. I don't care. Like, we're mostly just waiting for the, Right, rebels are no longer an issue then. That's good. Now they're actually part of our kingdom, officially. England paid all foreign debt of Austria. Again. What's England doing? What is their interest in this war? They're not even allied. So weird. Okay, so we got cores here now. Meaning that we can make them into states as well. Which is absolutely worth it, because that's going to reduce the autonomy by a nice little chunk as soon as that's done. We can get two more cores, but I actually want to save up my points for now. For those ideas and stuff. This is the one that I really want right now, although this one is also, you know, pretty nice. 275, like, we're not going to be able to reach, well, America, that's for sure. We're not going to be able to reach America. Papal State said Burgundy says arrival, okay. Yeah, we're not going to be able to reach that with the extra 50%, so that won't do it. feel like this is a lot better for now. Just add 50 to it, and then we get the idea. Because if you're ahead in technology, then you get a nice bonus. If you fall behind too much, you're going to have to pay quite a lot more. Yeah, I think I'll save up for the technology over this. Even though I also really want that. We'll see. We'll see how things play out. Like, we just want to make sure that we can discover more things as well. We're 2 years ahead. But it'll take 3 years before we can get it, so it's not gonna matter. We're also still waiting for colonialism to spread. Which is a kind of slow process because Portugal has to actually start doing it. Okay, we'll just wait. Let's see, let's grab one more unit. Oh, we can have two more now. Hey, I'm not turning that down. If I can have 15,000 units instead of 13,000, then I'm gonna do that. Because that's a pretty decent army. I wanna take these guys out. Actually, if I could just vassalize them, I'm gonna have to take this. But I could also just vassalize all of it. Which might be like a lot easier. But I'm not sure if that's even true. But at least like the Holy Roman Empire won't like demand that I release them. So that part's pretty good. Are you actually protecting trade? Because you're just sitting there. Like, you're just sitting straight in that node. Just kind of chilling. We are almost the biggest player here. That's a thing that we could do. We could build some more ships. Why not? Get me some barks. Yeah, let's get four barks for now. Actually, make that five. I'm rich now. Make it five. Yeah, that'll be good. That way we can actually increase our trade power over there. Honestly, it would be kind of nuts to, okay, we have to fabricate another claim. But it would be kind of nuts to actually beat England in terms of trade power, like this quickly, at least for me. Like, I don't know if that's any good. It's just I've never done that before. Yeah, just walk over there. Walk over there. You'll be okay. Yeah, you'll make it. All right, so we're getting some ships. We should probably also get another explorer soon, though. Right, we're getting 7 points. We could set our national focus to the diplomatic, which adds 2 points but takes one from the other ones. And I'm not entirely sure that that is worth it because our heir has horrible administrative skill. Just terrible. So we might actually be better off saving up for now and then changing our focus later because you can only change it once every 10 years or so, I believe. So I don't want to get like too hasty and kind of screw myself over in the long run. Alright, so apparently, okay. Okay, no longer have a reason to declare war on these guys. We're still waiting for that truce anyway. That's going to be another 6 or so years. Allied to Munster, okay. Not that dangerous, especially since I can actually call in Liège, which are, you know, they're quite big, and Saxony. And if that's the case, I don't even need France and Castile. Okay, well there goes another dude. These are all pretty bad. I don't care about my navy morale. Because that's only, like, that only deals with battles. So what we could do is just pay some of these people to go away. Like, I'll just give him 20 ducats and he'll leave. And then at the beginning of the next month, another guy will show up that I can hire. And let's hope that's a better guy. That's the main thing here. Navy morale, I laugh. I laugh at your navy morale. I don't need none of that. Give me something better. England, what are you doing? So far, they've paid well over 300 ducats for Austria. I wish I could see how much money they have. But I don't think that's a thing. So I don't know, but they're wasting their money on it, on Austria, and I don't honestly know why. Are they fighting the Ottomans or something? They're not. Right, so these guys actually occupied that province, so they must have walked all the way around or something. Genoa's growing. I think they used to have this province, but now they're like in Crimea. Which is very strange, but okay. I guess I respect that. Seems dangerous, though. They're fighting the Ottomans. So weird. All this stuff is just so weird to see. Right, this island's now the Ottomans as well. Venice. Because I think this is where the knights used to be. Which I always found to be a pretty fascinating, I guess, country or nation or whatever. But they're not anymore. They're now gone. Alright, how are we doing? On that technology there. Like, I just want to start colonizing. I've been talking about this for like an hour or so now. And I can't colonize. Let me colonize stuff, man. Oh, what are you doing? They're fighting Trier. Who's out at Frankfurt. Which is very small, isn't it? Where's that? Frankfurt. I want to know if they're big or small, or that they're small, very small. You know what, buddy? You're an idiot for calling me into another war, but sure. I could give you a hand. They have some other allies as well, so I don't really have to do too much. Yeah, that's not a battle that Trier will be able to win. The Peasants' War in Hungary. Okay, apparently peasants are burning stuff down. I like how Liège declares war and they're not actually the person that's like taking provinces right now. Let's see. It seems as if there is a great man in one of the provinces who has some rather intriguing ideas on how to create better fortifications. However, he's reluctant to leave his hometown. We could say the entire country needs him and we'll gain a military engineer that we can then hire. Or we could say let him stay home and then this province will actually gain a lot of defensiveness until the end of the game. Which is, to me, that seems like a better deal. Because I don't really need to hire this guy anyway right now. It's basically what I'm getting right now is a completely free bonus. So I'm not turning that down. The heir Margaretha breathes heavily. She has been lying in bed for 3 days now. And reflected into beads of sweat on her forehead is the fear in her attendant's eyes for her life. Margaretha might not make it through the night unless something's done. So we could get a trained medicus, which will... There's like a 50-50% chance of her living or dying. Or we could say, oh, you know, pray for her life. And we'll gain... If she lives, we'll gain a lot of legitimacy. But if she dies, then that's not the worst thing in the world. Because I don't... Like, she's not super bad, but her claim's weak. Right? Like, I would definitely prefer a better heir than her. Let's just pray. If she lives, that's great for her legitimacy. Let's do it. Yep, super dead. Okay, that's not a very much better heir, but at least the claim is strong right there. And that's something that actually is quite nice. What are you doing there, Frankfurt? What are you trying to play at? Okay, we took that. Let's take Cologne now. Wait, why is Cologne not Cologne? That's weird. I don't know what happened there. But apparently Cologne doesn't belong to Cologne. See, here's the thing. I don't actually want Liège to grow. So I'm going to try and occupy some provinces. And, okay, Clave is trying to do some stuff. I'm going to occupy some provinces. I'm going to peace out in a separate deal yet again. I want to see if I can possibly... Just vassalize Trier and just end the war that way. I'm not sure that's actually what happens, but I'd like to try. What is this? What is that? What is your plan there? Tell me about that. Okay, this guy's running in there. He's not gonna make it though, not in time. I like how they're not even bothering me. They're just letting me sit here, calmly sieging this stuff down. That's very nice of them. How am I earning this much money right now? Spoils of war. I'm earning a lot of money. Apparently trade is booming. That's a lot of my income is coming from trade. Right, so that's actually really nice then. Anything that gives me trade efficiency right now is like super valuable. Okay, please occupy. Why is it Liège that occupied this? It should be me. I'm the one doing the heavy lifting here. You guys are just dying like idiots. We're also paying a lot of money for our army and our two forts that we have. Royal marriage with Saxony's ended. Right, they have an heir though. Let's just get another one. I like Saxony, and honestly, like, they're not in my way or anything. So we can definitely like be allies and sort of help each other out, you know. We're like just far enough away that we can sort of gang up on the people in between our countries. It's pretty sweet. It's a true love story. All right, take that, please. Come on. England and Austria are now military allies. Are you serious? That's not very beneficial for me. Then again, I don't think Austria's just gonna like try to like beat me down. All right, we took Cologne. All right, let's go beat down that army maybe. Actually, no, I'm just gonna sit around here and do absolutely nothing. Yeah, I can't vassalize anyone. I could ask for war reparations, but apparently that's too much to ask for. We'll lose 25 prestige. Right, you gotta wait a year. Okay, fine, I'll wait. I'll just wait around a bit. Please occupy my name. Thank you. Thank you. Please do that. Occupy my name. Do what? I don't think they're actually gonna do it. Like, that barely happens, apparently. But I would just love to have a much higher war score so I can get a sweet deal. And just peace out and make sure that Liège doesn't grow too strong. Okay. Our ruler just died. On the bright side of things, like this sucks, but like she's a babbling buffoon apparently. On the bright side of things, we got like a decent electress. Okay. So like she's giving me like a bunch of points, which aren't that bad. She's actually better than our heir. So like that's a thing. All right, we're gonna grab the diplomatic technology, absolutely. And then yeah, I should probably grab this as well then. There we go. So we're at administrative technology. Like all technologies are at 9. If we get this to 10, we can actually form the Netherlands as soon as we have this province. And then it'll be official. We'll actually be the Netherlands. See, why did you occupy that in my name, but not this? It's strange. This is very strange. All right, they have an alliance with Frankfurt. We could tell them to drop that. Could tell them to release that as a sovereign nation. We are actually allowed to peace out right about now. Give this to Cologne. I mean, I'd rather they give it to Cologne than that they... That's too much. Okay. I would much rather that they give it to Cologne than Liège. Do that. Give that to Cologne. I mean, it is, after all, Cologne. And then I'm gonna have to ask you to cancel your alliance with Frankfurt and then also give me war reparations and like a bunch of cash, maybe? Oh, that's too much to ask for. Right, well, 14 gold it is. I am peacing out, boys. See you later. There we go. That's no longer on the table. Now belongs to Cologne. See ya, Liege. I don't need you to grow too quickly. Also, Frankfurt is like, should be pieced out of the war. But they're not. But they're no longer allied to Trier. So that was part of the deal. Yeah, now I hope that the war like turns out badly for this guy. Yeah, he's not very happy about that whole separate peace thing, but... Military access from Liege. Oh, I'm sorry, that's a no. That's a no as well. That's their ally. Please lose. Because, you know, we're allies right now, but soon we won't be. We're neighbors after all, and soon enough I will want your kingdom for myself because, like, I helped you grow and now you belong to me. It makes a lot of sense if you think about it. Alright, maybe not privateer. Oh, we could privateer there. That's a lot of cash to be earned. All we gotta do is save up our diplomatic power and just get an explorer and actually explore. That's what we need. Okay, they got allies with Clave and Munster. That is potentially dangerous, but not too bad. I think we can deal with them all. With our allies. I'm not even sure why they called me into this war. I mean, they're clearly doing alright. So I don't know why they needed my help with that, but sure. Okay. Can we have 16 units? Nope, we cannot. Ooh, but we're not too far away from it. Well, we're kind of far away from it, but we'll be able to have 16 in, like, not too long. Nope, no military access, buddy. I don't want anybody helping out these dudes. So Savoy should now be at war with Austria. Yes, they are. Oh, this is gonna be a right mess as well. They're war with Milan, which isn't that big, but they got Ravensburg, Burgundy, and Austria. Like, that's pretty bad. Yeah, this could be pretty bloody over here. Venice is very large, but they're apparently fighting Austria now. This is a mess. This is a very big mess. The Ottomans are also still fighting. They're going after this area. Okay, well, at least it's like, you know, nice and far away from my country. So I don't really have to worry about the Ottomans right now. And we're earning score, so that's really sweet. Okay, autonomy is like going up really, really slowly down there. New monarch for Burgundy. Okay, we gotta wait another 4 years before we can declare war. Okay, let me just speed it up a little bit because what I want is to get 50 diplomatic power. Get that explorer, send him away. Opposing factions in the military are advocating different tactics. We need to back one of them to end the bickering. Either more fort defense for 10 years or better siege ability. I'm gonna go with siege ability here. Since I am actually planning on fighting these guys in the pretty foreseeable future. Are you done with your war? Yes, they are. Right, oh. So they released these guys as a sovereign state again. They lost not much, I guess, in terms of land. They're still pretty good. I made them give this to Cologne. And then they had to give that up too, but that's about it. Like, it's not too big a deal. Okay, so at least, you know, Liege didn't grow too big or anything. That's like the main thing that I wanted to prevent. And I think it's looking good. Okay, here we go. We have 50 points now. So we're going to recruit another explorer. And explore we shall. We're going to go to the North Atlantic coast. Or actually the American East Coast, maybe. Go to America. Show me America. Because I can see Portugal is like all over these islands. The Antilles. We're not going to get those, sadly. Stupid Portugal. They're actually allied to Castile. It's as it should be now. Wait, these guys are fighting Morocco? Why? Oh, that's so weird. I've never seen that happen before. Okay. Anyway, guys, that's going to be it for now. I hope you all enjoyed the video. In the next part, we're going to hopefully start colonizing because I really want to. We'll be recovering our manpower and potentially starting to fight these guys because we need this province to finish the Netherlands. So all we really need is this province and this technology, and we can finally officially form the Netherlands, the Dutch nation. And that's gonna be it. So, yeah, thanks for watching, guys. I hope you enjoyed, and I'll talk to you later.